This is the first segment to the book that is being written about JJ's story. Please listen to it in its entirety. To a family used to the warm, comfortable climate of sunny California, the unsettled month of February in Oklahoma felt like being caught up in a mean-spirited game of tug-of-war with Mother Nature while she tried to make up her mind about being either icy cold or not quite warm enough. It was hard to trust the weather enough to make any real plans. And as the temperature cycled between the 20s and the 50s, every few days, the Rodriguez family struggled to adjust. No matter the number on the thermostat, the famed Oklahoma winds dropped the feels-like temperature to unbearable levels, and at times with a ferocity that almost hurt. The uncertainty of it could be unnerving, and it was an ongoing challenge to keep their seven young children active and engaged without becoming bored within the confines of the small house they rented in Oklahoma City suburb of Spencer. As the calendar turned to the 22nd, though, the young family awoke to a happy surprise of a warm day in a cold February. It was Sunday, and with the temperature expected to climb to the near 60 degrees, Cassie knew her children would enjoy getting outside and playing in the front yard as the day warmed. It would also give her little space to prepare the chicken she was cooking for lunch, and to see her husband, Jose, briefly in between his two jobs. Jose was home and running late and needed to catch a quick shower before going to his second job. By day, he worked in the dispensary, and when he finished there, he went to his next job as a forklift operator. Most of his days were incredibly hectic, and this Sunday was no different. He was happy to see the weather had warmed enough that his kids could play outside today. As the afternoon began, 13-year-old Sophie, 11-year-old Chloe, 4-year-old Delilah Ann all played in front of the yard along with baby JJ, just 2 months shy of his second birthday. Occasionally, 5-year-old Elise would come outside, but she eventually rejoined her parents in the house. With the front door open, Cassie held their 8-month-old baby, Olivia, as she watched her children play, the girls with the fake flower bed and JJ with his giant teddy bear. After putting the chicken in the oven, Cassie went back to the front door to tell the kids the food would be done soon, but in the meantime, there was water, chips, and juice on the table if they wanted some. "Okay, Mom," they answered back as they continued their play, enjoying the warm sunshine of the day. Cassie glanced around, her eyes last falling on JJ, before she turned to go back inside as she heard Jose turn the shower off and she went to take him his slides. Cassie quickly went to her room to put the baby down so she could check on lunch when she saw Olivia also needed a diaper change. In this 60-second span that lapsed from when she was looking at JJ playing to hearing Jose turn off the shower, she heard it. Just out of the shower, Jose heard it right then, too. It was a loud snarling sound, like a dog fight. An ominous sound that immediately made both Jose and Cassie stop in their tracks. Jose ran the 5 short steps to the window and opened it to a scene of unbelievable horror. The young father saw his 1-year-old son, JJ, being dragged viciously off the front lawn by several large pit bulls.
One dog was locked onto JJ's face, another one on his arms, and another was pulling him in the opposite direction by his legs, groin and stomach, biting him everywhere. Simultaneously, Cassie saw Jose run out of the shower without the shoes she had brought him. As she heard him scream a guttural no, Cassie watched as if in slow motion as Jose ran towards JJ and started to kick the dogs. As she faced the window, a puff of wind blew the curtain back, and suddenly she saw JJ's skull exposed in the February sun. The mother laid her baby down and ran to the front yard as her daughters ran inside screaming, "The dogs took JJ." Cassie heard Jose screaming, "Get my gun," as he continued to kick and tried to single-handedly fight off what now appeared to be 5 pit bulls engaged in a ferocious, bloodlust attack. The dogs were trying to carry the young boy off into their backyard, but as soon as Jose saw a small opening, he slid in between his son and the dogs and tried his best to cover JJ with his body. He first secured JJ's legs because they were the only limbs not being bitten at the moment. He got the legs underneath him, then one arm under him while covering JJ's face, which had already been severely mauled. Jose would hit one dog, fight it off, and then another would come from another direction. Each time, it felt like being assaulted and rushed from another side. Jose and JJ seemed to be caught in an impossible blitz of slashing teeth, snarling, and ferocious, relentless biting that was incredibly physically powerful. As Cassie watched helplessly screaming, it seemed like the dogs were engaged in a tug-of-war with her tiny son. Chloe rushed in, dialed 911, as the neighbors heard the commotion and began coming out with bats and guns to see what they could do to help. The owner of the pit bulls, however, only seemed to try to get his dogs one by one back into his yard, without ever asking if he could help in any other way or even calling 911. His behavior stood out as strange compared to everyone else who witnessed the attack. With the superhuman strength some parents get in life and death moments, Jose somehow managed to fight off four other dogs. The last dog had JJ's arm in his mouth, and Jose kept hitting and headbutting the dog because his face and head was all he had left to fight with, since the rest of his body continued to cover JJ. He could only try and shield JJ with his own face, and his eye quickly blackened, and the entire right side of his head and body became bruised in the struggle. The last dog was not letting go. Jose put his hand into the dog's mouth, shoving it deeply back into the throat as hard as he could, past the sharp bloody teeth that were tearing he and his son to shreds. The dog finally let go. Jose got up off the ground as he cradled JJ and ran as fast as he could. Cassie saw her husband running towards her with her son's limp body and began screaming, "They killed JJ! They killed JJ!" She could not imagine he was alive. JJ's face was literally hanging off, and Cassie saw that both of his eyeballs were drooping down while blood squirted from his neck. Looking down at his son, Jose saw that he had been scalped and felt how limp his body was in his arms and thought for sure JJ was dead. He turned the little boy around, and suddenly, to his surprise, JJ started to scream. The sound of his son's sudden voice filled Jose with a brief shock of hope until he saw what the dogs had done to JJ's face. They had literally ripped his face off. Cassie stood in shock as she watched her husband remain calm, completely calm, as he held the broken body of their son in his arms. He rubbed JJ's back softly and kept saying, "It's going to be okay. You're okay. It's okay." He had fought for and protected him, kept calm, and he had kept him alive. In that prolonged moment of terror and shock, Cassie looked in awe at her husband, remembering how he had delivered JJ when he was born, and how now he had kept him in this world. From that moment on, for the rest of her life, Jose would be forever Cassie's superhero.